everyone, this is Lorraine, and today I'm coming to you with my next polish review video. And so I'm just going to show you what I'm going to use. I knew I wanted to do a particular stamping design or use this particular image, so I picked my colors based upon the image. So the first color, or I guess the main base color I'm probably going to use is this color here. This is by Barielle. I've never used a Barielle polish, and I have a few of these, and I've been meaning to use them, but I just hadn't got around to it. I got so many. So I wanted to use this one, and this one is called Aura Angora. Sorry. There we go. It's better. So it's this kind of like a mustardy yellow type of tan color, kind of peanut buttery, yellowy mustard color. And the reason why I chose this is because I've been dying to do that lion image. So I figured this is the closest, you know, kind of the color of a lion, I guess. And then the next color, because I wanted that color to really pop and stand out, I'm going to use this really deep, dark green color. This is by Wet n Wild from the Mega Last collection, and it has the brush that I love, that really nice curve. Sorry, I'm trying to adjust my lighting so it's not like directly. Hopefully that's better. So this is the brush, or how the brush looks like. It's got that perfect curve. Anyway, and this one is called Poison Ivy. And so those are the two colors that I'm going to use. And I think I'm also going to use this glitter by Milani. It actually is a really bright, like a kind of lime greenish, unfortunately. Oh my god, I cannot. Oh, the lighting. So it's this green color, and this one, oh, that's right, this one is a textured one, so I'm not sure if I'm going to use this one or not. I may do, yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and use it. And this one, it's called Sugarcoated. Again, and it's this bright green color, and I'm going to put that over one of the nails with the green. So I'm going to go ahead and get it set up so I can get started. Okay, so I am back, and this is the finished polish application, and I just did the same on both hands. And so that is the main look that I was going for. I really like how the mustardy yellowy color stands out against the deep forest green color. So first I want to talk about the Barielle color, which is called Aura Angora. It's this very pretty mustardy type yellow, kind of like, I don't know, peanut butter mustard yellow color. And I really do like the color. I do not have on top coat on any of my nails. So it is, they're both colors are pretty shiny on their own. But again, I always use top coat. And I will say this, the Barielle color, it is a runnier formula than the other polishes that I've been using lately, so I did have a little mess to clean up, a little messier than the other ones. And also I did not get as clean of lines at the base of the nails. I had to do some cleanup using my brush around the base of the nail to get cleaner lines. I mean, it's a decent brush. I'm not as big a fan of this brush. It's a normal size brush, but I'm just not as, I don't know, there's something different about the brush than from the other polishes. But it's not a bad formula at all. One coat of each polish, so it's pretty opaque. I did two coats on my thumb. I always mess up my thumb somehow. But the rest of the nails, I did one coat. It did seem like it was kind of a little bit streaky, but as the polish kind of settled, it filled in a little bit. So it's an okay formula. I can't remember the price. Like, I believe these were in a set, like a pack of four, but I can't really remember. I think I got these either from TJ Maxx or either Marshall's or Burlington Coat Factory, one of the three places. I purchased this quite a several months ago and just hadn't got around to using it, but I have some other ones that I do also want to use, but when you have so many, it's hard to use them well or use them enough. But anyway, I do like the color. I love the color. The formula is just okay. It's not the worst formula I've used. It's not the best formula that I've used either, but it goes on pretty nicely. Again, opaque in one coat. Not a lot to say about this one just because I'm not like head over heels in love. I'm in love with the color, just the formula is okay. But considering the price, because I want to say they were in four packs for like $3.99 or something, so less than $1 a polish. Well, about $1 a polish, so not bad for the price, especially with the color payoff. It was really nice. But again, and it could have been just because my hands are bothering me a little bit today. I was doing a lot of typing and I cooked before I did my nails, which I generally do my nails first and then cook for that main reason, just because by the end of the day with the issues that I have with my hands, it gets kind of hard to really grip and hold the brush, especially with my left hand. But overall, a decent polish. If you can find them, check them out. They're okay formulas, but the color payoff, I must say, is absolutely fabulous. The next color that I used is by Wet n Wild Megalast, and I haven't used a Megalast in quite a while. And this one is called Poison Ivy. It's a deep shimmery forest green polish. It almost looks kind of like it could be black until you see like the light hits it and it's got the shimmer. So this is the formula, a decent formula. This is the brush. The brush is a really wide brush, so if you're someone who has really small nail beds, you probably will not like the Wet n Wild Megalast brushes, because they're already wide as it is and then they fan out and make it wider. So so like if your nails are like all this size, you're not gonna really like the larger brushes just because you will have a lot of mess. I did have a little mess on mainly my index fingers because they're thinner than my ring finger, but you do get really nice clean, you know, pretty clean lines just because the curve of the brush. I really do like that. And if you have wider nail beds, these are really good because you can almost apply it in one stroke. Honestly, I do like the formula. I like the color payoff. Again, one coat, it is like a really deep dark green, so it looks kind of black in some angles, but when the light hits it, you can see the shimmery green. So it's a really nice formula, applies really nicely, no particular issues. Both polishes dry pretty quickly, so if you do need to go over a spot a second time, I would go over that spot immediately. Don't wait, because if you do wait, you'll get like a little bald patch in that area. But that's typical with most polishes, especially if they dry faster. If they're slow drying polishes, then you have a little bit of more time to work with it. And I will say the same was with both polishes, because they both dry pretty quickly. So yeah, you want to make sure if you need to go over the spot a second time to go over it immediately, because I mean, they dry pretty quickly, and which I really like. So pleased with both colors. not as big a fan of the formula necessary, or actually I think it's more the brush than the formula, because the formula was actually pretty nice and opaque in one coat. Both polishes are opaque in one coat. This one, I believe it's something with the brush that I didn't really care for, because the formula, it applies nicely, opaque. It's a little bit runny, so you will have a little bit of mess. Because it's kind of runny, it doesn't stay in place like I like it to, so you can really, you know, work with it. But other than that, I mean, for the prices, $1.99, and these you can find for a couple dollars or in a pack of four for under maybe $6-$7, depending upon where you buy it from. Because I have seen these sets at varying prices amongst like Burlington, TJ Maxx, and Marshalls. So it just kind of depends upon where you go. But both decent polishes, but I love the color payoff. So that is it. Have you tried any of the Barielles? I don't see anyone ever talking. Oh, and it's still open. Whew, thank goodness. Whew. I don't see anyone talking about these polishes at all. So let me know if you've used them. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you, especially if what you think like about the brush versus the formula. If you think it's more the brush or the formula, or if you had no problems at all. So it could honestly just be me and my issues with my hand. So that is it. Thanks for watching. Stay polished at all times and have a great day. Bye.